I find myself having to. Oh my god, that is so adorable. Really? I was just gonna say, I find myself clicking everything to go, is this a part of the game? Or did he build this? And 9 times out of 10, it's not in the game, and he's built it out of like 70 objects. This is so cute. Oh, it's so. I mean, this bundle of wood has more character than some of the things I've built, guys. A house and a tree. Of course it is. Should I even look that up? It's a house and a tree, guys. Welcome back, my Planet Coaster friends. Johnny5 Live here. We are back with another Workshop Wednesday. And in today's episode, we're going to be looking at Dr.Papadodu's workshop featuring an assortment of fantasy items, Japanese items, Western items, and some other cool stuff. So stay tuned and let's check it out. Now, before we kick things off, there's quite a few new subscribers to the show this week since we did this last Wednesday. There's about 1,000 new subscribers. So to fill everybody in on this show, this is Workshop Wednesday, and we try to pick somebody from the Steam Workshop who has cohesive branding across all their items so that we can kind of show this to you guys and you can download a whole set of items to put in your park. That's the idea behind this. So we try to find someone that has a nice assortment of matching items. And Dr.Papadodu has been somebody that I've had my eye on, and in my opinion, he is a master builder. So we're going to take a closer look at his items today. This show, hopefully you guys are enjoying it. Let me know down in the comments below, because YouTube analytics are saying that this is my worst series on my channel. And unfortunately, that's just the way it is right now. Hopefully it picks up later on. But this is one of the hardest videos that I do in terms of setting up and editing and the amount of work that goes into it. It's just the hardest video with the least amount of views, which is okay, because one of my plans with Channel 5 Gaming from the beginning was to try and build a gaming community, and it just so happened that Planet Coaster found me and it turned into a Planet Coaster channel. So I wanted to kind of reinvent myself and keep things in that direction, but now focused more towards Planet Coaster. So Workshop Wednesday is sort of my way of bringing that community closer. By choosing someone to put on the show and showing all their items, you guys may get inspired by it and create some amazing things yourself. You may go over to the Creator's Workshop, subscribe to all their stuff, follow them, and get talking to them. So it's just my way of getting everybody to interact as one big, you know, Planet Coaster family. So I want to keep pressing on with the show, and hopefully you guys want me to keep doing it. I just want to keep reinventing myself and adding new things to the show. And I thought this idea, when I came up with this idea, I thought it would be a good one, but the YouTube analytics are telling me otherwise. And right now I'm just being stubborn and ignoring it, because I think it's important to keep everybody as a tight little Planet Coaster family. And before we jump into this, I kind of want to mention to everybody, the reason I love the Workshop Wednesdays and the reason I came up with the Workshop Wednesdays is, some of you guys may not know this and a lot of you are new, but I worked in the game and film industry for about 10 years. I started as a QA tester, art QA tester specifically. I moved over to a junior artist role. I did some animation on some films and some different games. And then from there, I eventually moved into an indie company where we did 3D art for the Unreal Engine. I did that for the last 2 years or so. But one of my favorite things to do is gawk over art. I love looking at 3D art. I love looking at game art and that sort of thing. So this to me is just a fun hobby, and I want to bring you guys in on it, but also give you guys ideas for your Planet Coaster creations and also give you things to go find and download. So it's kind of like a, you know, kill three birds with one stone kind of show for me. So I just love looking at art and, you know, really getting a good look at things. So just a little pastime of mine is something fun that I enjoy. So hopefully you guys enjoy it as well. So enough with the pleasantries, the introductions, and all that jazz. Let's jump right into it, guys. So this is Dr.Papadodu's workshop. I don't know if I'm pronouncing that right. We're just going to call him Dr. Papa. And he's got this cute little Gulpy logo. Now, every time I see Gulpy, I think Dr. Papa. He's the new mascot for me. So anyways, he's got a wonderful workshop, almost 1,000 followers. That is legit, guys. That's really tough to do. Yeah, he's put in a lot of fantastic work here. 3 pages of really amazing stuff. He has a little bit of fantasy, a little bit of Japanese, a little bit of Western, some castles and stuff, some really cool garden work. He even has some Aztec stuff in here, some ruins and jungle temples. Very cool. And then he has some Asterix stuff in here, Gallic fairy tale Asterix. I believe that was a kids TV show back in like the 90s or something. I'd have to Google that. So I pulled it up on Google. So this is it. I remember this from as a kid. I think there was like comics or something as well. So this is where he got the inspiration from, I believe. See some of these buildings, the tree house, the little houses here. That's where he got his inspiration. Very cool. Dr. Papa's workshop. Come check it out. Follow him, subscribe to some of these items, rate them. He's done a lot of fantastic work. So as you can see here, I have it all like kind of laid out, but that was more for the thumbnail. I have a better one laid out so we can go through these one at a time, a little bit more spaced out. But there's some Western, some Japanese, some fantasy, or there's that Asterix stuff. And then some more fantasy. There's some blue and red, different themes, some little castles, and some Aztec. So we're going to get a better look at this. So I'm going to load up a different save. All right. So here we are at the different save. I believe Dr. Papa has 27 items on his workshop. So we have them all laid out here and we're just going to go through them one at a time. The first one we have here is the Japanese hat shop, and the roof even looks like a little hat. I love it. And these Japanese buildings are, I love these because it's something that is very, I guess, unorthodox to the game. It's not something that Planet Coaster provides you by default. It's very much its own theme, and all these little pieces, like very tedious job putting all these in. There's quite a bit of pieces in this one blueprint. It's pretty crazy. I mean, we could select this and take a look. That's 1,000 pieces, 7 different buildings to make this one little hat shop. And I love the way he's used the colors to really nail the theme. Just so much detail gone into this. I absolutely love it. So it's all this work just for a hat's fantastic. So I have to say this shop is fantastic. I love it. And all these little ornate details on the top. My God, so good. So we got a lot to go through. So I'm going to try not to spend too long on it, but I want to give you guys a good look at everything before moving on. But I love this style. Very good. All right, so the next one here is Japanese food shop and drink. And very similar to the last one we looked at, but this one's a 3-tiered layer, or three stories, three tiers, however you want to say it. Very cool. Love these little balconies and stuff. The windows are dancing a little bit. I don't know if there's two on top of each other or not, but that's okay. I tend to point that stuff out because of my art QA background. It's just a bad habit of mine where I'm forced to fix things when I see it, but nonetheless, it's just a pet peeve of mine. The building is amazing nonetheless, and I can't get over the amount of attention to detail gone into making these rooftops. It's just so amazing. All these little pieces. So well done, so well constructed, so much thought gone into it. Absolutely love it. And even just something to get these little very specific railings, he's gone and used the giant gates. So very cool indeed. So we got the cow's milk shop, milkshakes, and burgers. Love it. Very cool. So if you want to get some ideas from this, I definitely say come check out Dr. Papa's workshop, because the way he uses items is so inventive. It's very creative. He must have studied the pieces for a very long time, because some of the things I see him using, I would have never thought of. Next up is the Japanese lantern. Very cool. I love the lantern red and orange glow. Let's take a look at these really quickly at nighttime. We'll probably do a nighttime pass. Oh, wow. Oh, that looks so good. Look at that. These lanterns are amazing. Look at the way they glow like that. Wow, is that an extra light in there? That's amazing. I have to remember to use these lanterns when I'm building things, because I love the way they look and how well they illuminate the building. Look how nice that is. Wow. And these lanterns, man, I just want to use them everywhere. Holy smokes. All right, next up is the Japanese temple. This one's pretty nice. I love it. It's got similar style roof to the other ones, but it's much bigger and it has much more details. A lot of panels gone into this. I can imagine how tedious this must have been to do this, and I can really appreciate the effort. And I love this golden top to the temple. Really hits it home. These nice little golden elements to really sell the temple feel. And this big giant door on the front. Love it. And I also think the hedge plants are really suitable here. They fit very well. Very nice touches and these little stairs and everything. So many nice details. Really good. So these are the only four Japanese items he's made, I believe. But man, would they take some time to construct. So I'm looking forward to see if he makes any more in the future. You know, I would love to play around with some of this stuff and make a little Japanese village and have, you know, some really cool bridges going across using these lamps, some waterfalls, rocks. It gives me so many ideas and inspires me so much to play around with it. And even his thing back here would go really well with all of this. So we'll get a look at that in a second. Next up is the medieval tavern. Now look at this. Oh, it's so good. Now, this one pulls on my heartstrings, the way that Papa constructs these buildings. This is like my favorite kind of art style for fantasy games. It reminds me of many things. Fable, Final Fantasy, Baldur's Gate. I mean, you name it. I love it. It's so well done. It's so creative. It strays off the path of what Planet Coaster does with their medieval. It's very unique. I love it. There's so many unique details into this. And we go into the tavern and look at this. It has this very, it's a perfect tavern feel. Now I would love it if you could actually go, if it had an upper walkway with a little pathing up top so the people could go upstairs and sit. But that's me just being ambitious. Nonetheless, it's amazing in here. So we have another burger shop and a cosmic cow for this one. Love this. He's holding up kegs. That's brilliant. So many nice details. Very nice. So next up is the small store flowery. So it's a Hats Fantastic shop again, but I suppose it's supposed to be a flower shop. Again, I love the way he's used these roof pieces and made this really dynamic looking building. I love this on the edge here, just to add a little bit more character to the building. Not going overboard with the plant decorations, just a few touches here and there. Just enough to make it pop with a little bit of color. Absolutely love it. These little piggies. So cute. That's a quite a quaint little Hats Fantastic shop. Now this is the large medieval house. So I guess it could be an inn as well. Now just looking at all these buildings, I have to say something real quick. Like the orange tops, the blue tops. This kind of makes me feel like this is what I wish Stormwind City from World of Warcraft should have looked like. I mean, this is like the reinvented Stormwind City. I absolutely love this style. Everything looks so good. Love the upper balcony, stairs going up. Everything here tells a story. And that's one of the things that I try to do with my sci-fi, is I always try and tell a story, make things believable. And I can't praise this enough. at how much this really feels lived in and realistic. I mean, I really feel like somebody lives here, and there's a daily life and story that happens at this medieval house. So we have some shops here. We have a chief of beef, information booth, some bathrooms, little sitting area. Very cool. Some tables. And now these tables he's actually made as custom props, and we'll take a better look at that in a minute. But they are so clever. I think, yeah, these stairs are even custom, aren't they? Possibly. Not too sure. I haven't looked through many of the medieval pieces myself, since I'm kind of trying to finish a sci-fi world. So I'm not too familiar with everything. And again, really amazing job at doing this roof. It's got a unique style and feel to it. I love it. So the next one is the small medieval restaurant. Look at this. Love this ornate fence going around with literally all these little tiny hand-placed bricks. So cool. Again, really captured the essence of making this feel lived in. We got a little pirate up top, scoping out the area. He's just taking a break, looking for some people to trade with. We got another chief of beef. And is this a bathroom? I think so. Very nice. I love these little planters. I can't wait to move on to fantasy. And when I do, I will definitely be studying some of Dr. Papa's work here, because I love the way he uses things, and I would love to get an idea of how he puts these together. So hopefully you guys are just as inspired and you go check him out on the Steam Workshop. Next up is the Medieval Knights Restaurant. This is cool. There's a big knight out front. Awesome. So this one's the big restaurant. Let's take a look inside. Okay, all right, awesome. So this is what I was saying with that one. I said I wish we could go inside and go upstairs. Well, Dr. Pop is one step ahead of me. There we go. We got an upstairs balcony with benches and some stairs leading you up. This is amazing. All these decorations. So I can notice some similarities to the other ones. So there's some copy paste and then modification, which is very efficient use of the way he's used his buildings and then mixed them up by switching the roofs and the exterior up. Really smart and efficient. Love it. I can't wait to build me some fantasy. And this knight is badass. Next up is the large flowered medieval house. So lots of flowers on this one, lots of balconies, lots of little gardens and stuff. Very cool. Oh, look at this door. That is a wicked door. Oh, I got the house, it's not synced in properly. That's my fault. Very cool design on the front. I feel like the back could use a little something. Nonetheless, it's pretty amazing. I think this is something you could sync into more bigger buildings and cluster it better so you wouldn't need a back, or you could sink it into the side of a hill. So, very cool. Very pretty front to it. I love this little chimney design too. Oh, neat. Look at that. Very clever. All right, so next up we have the medieval table and chairs, the medieval table, and I think I'm missing the last one. It's a bench. So these may look like ordinary medieval chairs and tables, but they are far from ordinary in terms of how they were made. Look at that. All these pieces, he's really thinking outside of the box when he takes a piece and says, how can I use this? I mean, it's so freaking clever. Just to get the little details necessary, there's a whole, you know, board put into it. I mean, he didn't need to put that in. It would have still looked good. But that's what I'm saying. The attention to detail incorporated into these designs is, I appreciate it. And it's so freaking cool to see how innovative people can be. Look at this. This is the little thing where you put your arms and head in or whatever. The chopping block, I guess. I don't know what it's called. It turns that into a table. It's brilliant. Seriously. So these little things have so much more detail in terms of how he put them together. And it's pretty gnarly. Like, look at this. These little things. Is that supposed to be a cat? That's amazing. Is that... Okay. Oh, wow, it's a cat. Oh, my God, it's a sign. Look at that. See, I don't know this... Again, I don't know the fantasy pieces, but this little sign is amazing. Wow. And then you put it all together, and it's like a cat bench. That is so clever. Wow. All right. Moving on, we have the rock guitar garden. Now, look at this. It's used all the hedge plants. Really clean plants. Some pieces of wood. And then he's got little pieces of wood going down for the guitar strings. And the little tuners things are made out of, like, swords or something. I mean, this is, like, again, so innovative. So clever. And just such great use of everything. What is this? Everything I look at surprises me. It's a bell. Oh my god. This is so clever. Look at that. And I think it lights up. We got a few buildings that we have to look at again for nighttime, so we'll do that here. Wow. Look at this. The way it lights up just makes it feel so much softer and more inviting. Very cool. The backside's lit up a little bit too. It sparkles almost. So we look at these buildings at nighttime. Ooh, it's very warm and inviting. All of these. Wow. Very nice. And I love how each of his themes also feel different, and their lighting corresponds to their theme. It's a lot of attention to detail, is what I'm trying to say. Next, we have the Western Saloon. Very cool. Street Fox Coffee. Oh my god. I mean, it's perfect. Absolutely perfect. It's good to see that they had the ACs in the 1800s. Refurbished, right? Brought back. Very cool. I think this is a piece of pirates, but it fits so well here. Love this, like, little construction area up here, too. Let's take a look inside. A little wanted sign as well. Oh, wow. Look at this. See, everything feels lived in. Again, like, if you have a walkway up top, it's got to be a door. Make it believable. Love it. A little bit of dancing floors in here. Is this fixable? Yeah, it's fixable. Anyways, so we have a chief of beef and a coffee shop in here. Very cool. Love it. This is the Western Souvenir Shops and Toilets. So you get your souvenirs and toilets here. Dropping dookies in there. All right. Oh, look at this. Little gun on the wall. I love the souvenirs. Like, everything on the walls here. It's so fitting. What is this? It's trunks. Oh, very clever. Look at this. Iron hanger. So you buy TNT as a souvenir. Love it. This is so good. Just a memento. Just getting TNT for the moment, guys. Love it. This is so cute. Ooh, look at the backside. Again, just little elements to make it little bit more believable, a little bit more realistic. Just these small touches, like a shovel here, like someone was working. That's what really makes art stand out, guys. So take some notes from Dr. Papa here, because I love the little elements. Some rope hanging over here. Very cool. It all tells a story. This is the Western Hotel. Now, I love the change up between elevations on this one. How it has a whole half level before you go into the building. And the backside is lowered. So, very interesting architecture here. Oh, I love it. It's so clever. This is so much detail. And these little things that he's doing on top, it's really helps sell the building, the realism of it all. And just a little bit of like things going on up here, make it look like someone was working, a little hatch so they can get up and down. Adds that level of realism. Very cool. Let's go inside. Reception. It's an information booth and toilets again. Very cozy inside. Again, some stairs going up to a door, adding that lived-in feeling. Oh, this goes out to that back door that we're looking at. Very nice. It's so well thought out. Great job. And we're not even getting close to finishing, guys. We're like halfway there. All right, next we have the old small ruins. This is really cool. I love seeing, much like the Japanese theme, I love seeing this like Aztec theme, because it's something that's not normal, you wouldn't normally see in Planet Coaster, but if you use all these pieces and some, you know, overgrown vines and some, you know, vegetation and broken blocks, you can really sell the fact of like this ruins or temple or whatever you want to call it. This is really cool, the stepping stones. I think I was supposed to sink it in the ground a bit more, but I could see this, like, you know, just having a pond next to it, and, like, you could do so many cool things to this. Maybe even this is filled up with water just a little bit, if you sink it into the ground. I mean, it's beautiful. Love the theme. Here's the jungle temple. Very cool. Very good use of all these pieces. Wow, look at this. I thought that was a piece that was in the game, but it's actually something that's constructed up of a whole bunch of little parts. Wow. That's taking things to the next level, guys. It really is. That is so cool. Man. This is making me feel like I gotta up my game. Look at this. The time spent to get this. Oh, wow. Duplicate, rotate 15. Duplicate, rotate 15. Is that the trick? Oh, my God. And you look at it from a distance. You're like, yeah, I just put that thing on top. No, that's like 30 things. It's so clever. I'm freaking out. This is insane. So many pieces gone into this building. Let's see inside here. So really, this is like a centerpiece that you use to have all your pathways going through and your people just walk on through and enjoy the scenery. There's some fire. What is that? Okay, it's these. Next, we have the jungle waterfall. I mean, this is a lot of effort gone into this just to make a waterfall, and it's very fitting to everything we were just looking at. And it even fits the Japanese stuff, I think. I mean, if you had a nice hill here with the Japanese temple on top, very cool. I think it would fit very nicely. So many details. Wow, wow, wow. I guess I'm supposed to dig down the ground a bit and put a pond in here running out. And then you could have maybe a little bridge going across and the people walk by. Oh, so cool. gets me so inspired to make a little park with all this stuff. So hopefully you guys are inspired and go download this stuff and check it out. Next is the Gallic Fairy Tale House, House of the Druid, Asterix Set 3. Is this fixable? Not really. Nonetheless, I love the cobblestones. I didn't even know this was a thing. I mean, Dr. Papa has really spent his time studying these pieces and coming up with really interesting ways of using them all. Just the little tiny details to make a thatched roof feel more than just a thatched roof. I really appreciate that. The level of detail gone into taking things up a level. Look at the tops of this. This is all... Oh, what is this? Oh, cool. Piece from the pirate set. Just to make it all look like it's tied together nice and tightly. And then just some logs. So clever. I sound like I'm repeating myself a lot, guys. Sorry, but this is really innovative and clever. So... maybe I should just shut up and enjoy it all. Little cauldron. Some spoons on the wall. those are the new pipes from the winter update. And they are cauldron spoons. I can't get over the creativity in this. This is madness. And it's a gulpy shop. Great stuff. Now this one is the Manufacturer of Menhirs from Asterix Set 4. Don't know if I'm pronouncing that right. This one kind of reminds me of a Witcher 3 house. I only played it for a little bit, but it feels like a Witcher house. Very cool. So much time spent just getting these logs randomly spaced. So it gives it a nice texture going across. Going the extra mile again to make things look unique. Very amazing work. I find myself having to... oh my god, that is so adorable. Really? I didn't know that existed in this game. Is that, I was just about to say, okay, it doesn't exist in the game. He built it. But the little piggy, I'm pretty sure I've seen before. Yeah, I've put that in one of my parks. But I would have never thought to build him a little house. That is freaking adorable. My god. I was just going to say, I find myself clicking everything to go, is this a part of the game? Or did he build this? And 9 times out of 10, it's not in the game. And he's built it out of like 70 objects. So... this is very much all unique and quite hard to replicate unless you're Papa. Wow. It just fits so perfectly. Love the stumps for chairs. What? Like, let me guess, this table? Okay. All right. I thought that was like 30 pieces too. Although this fireplace is. Oh, this is so good. And again, little cauldron spoons. And it's a Chief of Beef shop. I know you guys hate it when I say Chief of Beef. Apparently it's Chief Beef. But I've been calling it Chief of Beef because he is the Chief of the Beef. So... gonna have to deal with it, guys. It's what I call it. Next is the blacksmith. Ooh, everybody's favorite fantasy shop to stop by in an RPG. Oh, you know what, guys? I've been in desktop mode this whole time. Hopefully the frame rate was okay. Desktop mode is for, yeah, in OBS is to show you guys my desktop. So it usually kind of stutters a little bit when... hopefully it'll be okay. I had this happen the other day, and it seemed to be okay. But should be running a little bit smoother now. Anyways, back to the blacksmith shop, everybody's favorite place to stop by when they're playing an RPG. Because they want to upgrade their weapons and get new armor. So you throw up in here, apparently, and you relieve yourself. Interesting. It's got a little shovel in there, heating up. Probably a billion pieces for whatever this is. Oh my god. This is so cute. Oh, it's so... I mean, I love how he just takes a box and brings it to life with 1,000 sticks. It's a bundle of wood. Because why not? And it looks... This bundle of wood has more character than some of the things I've built, guys. Maybe I'm being hard on myself. But you guys know what I mean. I'm just saying that Papa really brings things to life, even down to a bundle of wood. So amazing. Man, I love this stuff. I can't wait to make a fantasy park one day, because I'm definitely going to be coming back for this stuff. So good. It's a long video so far, guys. So hopefully everyone's still hanging in with me. This is the fairy tale house from Asterix. And look at this little pig pen. So cute. There's so much life in each one of these creations. Some of my favorite blueprints in Planet Coaster, for sure. These are just so well constructed. So this is similar to the one we already looked at. It just has a different exterior. So let's see if the inside's a little different. It might be. I think it was the other way around. Let's take a quick look. Yeah, it is the other way around. Okay. Again, efficient use, like he flipped the building around and then swapped the fronts and backs to make them feel different, but also to save time. Very efficient artist. Love it. Love it, Papa. Great work. And then this is a house in a tree. Of course it is. Should I even look that up? It's a house in a tree, guys. Oh, the spiraling staircase. So good. Wow. I don't know what it is about spiraling staircases, but they've always fascinated me. And one time I tried drawing one in three-point perspective. And that was fun. I got it done, but it took like 6 hours. Wow. Such a cute little house in a tree. Very cool. We did see this when I showed the Google images at the beginning of the episode. We did see this was in one of the Asterix screenshots. I guess this is one of the main things in the show. And then we have the mini castle shop. Very cute. Very quaint. Very castle-y. Not too much to say about this one. It's just right. It's just perfect. Great use of the building tops again. Nice little towers and stuff. Again, really clever use of the... I'm supposed to sink it in a little bit further, but he's going to use chandeliers just to give ropes pulling down the sides. I mean, everything in this park, in these blueprints, is very innovative. Thinking outside the box, 100%. Now, the last one is the small manor. Very nice. Very clean, very rich feeling. Wealthy. You can't go in this one. This one's just for looks. Nonetheless, it's amazing. And let's take a look at this stuff once again at nighttime. Because we didn't get a look at this row. And I forgot to look at the western stuff at nighttime. Very good use of the white lights for this building. Rather than having it warm, it's a little bit more bright. I think that works really well. Again, like, even the way Papa's used the lighting is, it's very spot on. This one could use a little lantern maybe out front. Nonetheless, it's good. Nice little warm glow on this. This one looks great. Love this. The temple looks amazing. And Western. Perfect. Ooh, this one's bright. They're selling lanterns here. Very nice. Alright, hopefully you guys made it through this video. It was a long one. Before we go, guys, this is why I was in desktop mode, because I need to show you guys this stuff, and I forgot to switch back. So hopefully the video turned out alright on your guys' end. Anyways, once again, this is Dr.Papadodu's workshop. Hopefully I'm saying that right. Come follow him. He's awesome. Subscribe to some of this stuff. A lot of it has 4 and 5 stars. Amazing work. Definitely a master builder, in my opinion. Very good work. Love it. Come rate this stuff. Follow him and check it out for yourself. As always, the links will be down in the description below. And if you guys have a workshop submission of cohesive items that you would like to feature on the show, be sure to send it into channel5gad@gmail.com. So if you find something top quality like this, don't hesitate to send it in as a recommendation, because it makes, you know, sometimes you can't always find the diamond in the rough, or whatever you say. You know, sometimes you got to dig through the workshop before you realize that somebody has, you know, 20 items that are all amazing. And when you stumble across something like this, you really, it's good to make people aware of it. And that's the whole purpose of this show. So hopefully you guys enjoy it, and hopefully you made it through this one. If you did, please be sure to like, and if you're new, be sure to subscribe. And that's going to do it for this episode of Workshop Wednesday, everybody. I will see you tomorrow for, what is it? Park Spotlight? We'll see. All right. See you guys.